다음 목적지는 숨겨진 아이비로 알려진 곳입니다. 2018년에는 로이터가 선정한 세계에서 가장 혁신적인 대학 순위에서 10위 안에 들었죠. 바로 벤더빌트 대학교입니다. 벤더빌트 대학교는 치열한 입학 경쟁률을 자랑하는 중간 규모의 사립 연구대학으로 테네시주 내슈빌 시내에 자리 잡고 있습니다. 벤더빌트 대학교는 US 뉴스 앤 월드 리포트가 대학 순위를 집계하기 시작한 1984년부터 매년 전국 25위 안에 들고 있죠. 2020년에는 14위에 올랐다고 해요. 이곳은 수준 높은 교육과정, 넉넉한 재정지원, 그리고 높은 학생 행복도로 유명합니다. 실제로 프린스턴 리뷰에서는 미국 대학 중 벤더빌트 대학교를 학자금 지원 부분에서 3위, 학생 행복도 부문에서 2위, 아름다운 캠퍼스 부분에서 2위로 선정했어요. 이런 혁신적인 대학교를 더 자세히 알아볼 준비 되셨나요? 함께 가시죠! 저는 미국 미시간 대학교에서 경제학을 공부하며 유학생활을 시작한 이현진입니다. 여러분과 함께 미국에서의 대학생활을 엿보며 학생과 교직원을 직접 만나 더 깊은 이야기를 들어보려고 합니다. 미국 명문 대학들을 탐방할 준비가 되셨나요? 그럼 출발합니다. 벤더빌트 대학교는 테네시주 내슈빌에 있습니다. 많은 사람들이 내슈빌을 미국의 음악 도시라고 하죠. 음악 산업의 중심지이기 때문인데요. 또 다른 별명도 있습니다. 20곳이 넘는 고등 교육기관이 있어서 남부의 아테네라고도 하죠. 벤더빌트 대학교는 어떤 점이 특별한지 알아보기 위해 학부 입학처의 존 게인스 처장님을 만나보았습니다. Hey, John. Good to meet you.
Hi, Emily. It's nice to meet you, too.
So what makes Vanderbilt a special place?
Vanderbilt is really amazing. Our students come from all over the United States and all around the world. But what I love about it, even though it's an ultra-selective university and one that's really well-known everywhere, is that our student body, when it comes together, has this really collaborative, really creative, really friendly vibe that makes people feel at home regardless of where they're from.
So I've read that Vanderbilt is highly ranked in an unusual category, happy students. Can you tell me more about that?
Vanderbilt has an emphasis for undergraduates on residential education. We believe in the power of community. We place students in community with one another. We want people learning from one another. We want people willing to engage with their fellow students, as well as with the faculty and staff who are here to support them. One of the other things about Vanderbilt that's very unique at the undergraduate level is that as part of our graduation requirement, we ask every student to complete an immersive experience through our Immersion Vanderbilt program. And you might center your learning experience in a study abroad opportunity or a research opportunity or an internship opportunity or some kind of creative endeavor. But the cool thing about Immersion Vanderbilt is that you'll design the project on your own with help from an academic advisor, and then you'll implement the project on your own, and then you'll bring it back to campus to share with everybody here so that we can all learn from whatever you've done.
Tell me about the academics at Vanderbilt.
Vanderbilt is a national research university in Nashville, Tennessee, and that in and of itself is unique, right? Nashville's an amazing city, fast-growing, creative, collaborative kind of culture that permeates our campus as well. We're an interesting collection of 10 colleges and schools, four of which enroll undergraduates, our College of Arts and Science, our School of Engineering, the Peabody College, which is one of the top schools of education in the United States, and Blair, which is our School of Music. So regardless of which of the four undergraduate schools a student chooses to begin their journey at Vanderbilt with, they can take classes in any of the four along the way and have majors in one, minors in another. There's a huge emphasis on interdisciplinary study here, so we're a really great place for students who have multiple interests.
그런 학생이 바로 3학년 애슐리 로시입니다. 애슐리 씨는 고등학교 졸업 후에 어떤 전공을 선택할지 정하지 못했다고 하는데요. 다행히도 벤더빌트 대학교에서 알맞은 길을 찾을 수 있었다고 하네요. 안녕하세요. 반갑습니다.
안녕하세요.
What drew you to Vanderbilt?
What I was looking for when I was applying for colleges was the level of flexibility and ability to explore different areas of subject. whether that was being able to like double major or, you know, take different classes I wanted to, or having like a wide array of different clubs that I could join. Vanderbilt really stuck out to me when I was looking for that process because I was able to explore so much. Really, if you ask anyone at Vanderbilt, they are most definitely like at least doing a double major or adding a minor to their major.
So you're pre-law, studying human and organizational development, but also overall performance. How does the major fit into what you want to do?
I came into Vanderbilt as a OBO performance and communications double major, and the reason why I wanted to major in those two majors was because OBO was such an integral part of me that I just didn't want to let it go when I went to college. But I came into Vanderbilt and decided that I actually wanted to do the business side instead of more of like the communication side, so decided to change my major to human and organizational development. And I had to fulfill a class, so I took Introduction to Philosophy, and I fell in love with that class. The whole concept of like logic and conditional reasoning and everything like that was just so interesting to me that I found my newfound passion for law and thought that maybe I could utilize law in music, and then so decided that I wanted to take the music copyright route, and that's how I became pre-law as well. That's really the nature of what Vanderbilt students do. I think it's really hard for a high school student to know exactly what they want to do when they go to college and like what they want to do for the rest of their lives, and college is the place for you to explore, and Vanderbilt really does that for you.
벤더빌트 대학교는 수준 높은 교육과정과 기숙사 제도 덕분에 학생들이 자기 목표에 맞는 맞춤 교육을 받을 수 있는 활기찬 분위기를 형성했습니다. 그런데 2020년에는 강의가 온라인으로 전환되는 바람에 이런 분위기가 사그라들 수밖에 없었죠. 벤더빌트 대학교는 새로운 길을 찾아야 했습니다. So John, with colleges going virtual last spring, how did Vanderbilt innovate?
Vanderbilt, like everybody else, had to pivot and had to rethink how we were delivering education, how we were delivering the residential experience. We were able to open this fall, and some students chose to be remote learners, but we did open the campus. We'd made some changes to the residential colleges, and so we had students that were here in Nashville on campus, living and learning in socially distanced classrooms and in kind of different kinds of learning styles than we ever thought we would offer before. And one of the examples of that is what has become the largest class in Vanderbilt history that was hosted online about the 2020 presidential elections.
벤더빌트 대학교 역사상 가장 큰 강의를 맡았던 교수 중 한 분이 바로 김은재 교수님입니다. 한국인이자 벤더빌트 대학교의 정치학 교수죠. 안녕하세요. 반갑습니다.
안녕하세요. 반갑습니다.
You're doing some fascinating research about the American dream. Can you tell me more about that?
A lot of newspapers would say, well, American dream is just a mirage. It doesn't exist anymore statistically and economically, if you look at the facts. However, if you look at the public opinion polls, the belief in American dream is still persistent and very strong. So how do we explain that discrepancy? And my answer tends to be the media, because that's what people consume, and media shapes the way we think about the world. It turns out that what attracted millions of American eyeballs for the past 20 years has been a particular type of reality TV show that have a same narrative. That in this country, anyone who works hard can get ahead with any random talents. And if you believe in the American dream, well, why care about welfare? Because, well, you should work harder. And I'm arguing that all these TV shows, whether it was intentional or not, is promoting that particular attitudes amongst the American public. Why? Because they're watching it every day, 5 hours.
That's fascinating. So what makes the political science program at Vanderbilt special?
We have a fantastic American politics program. We have great scholars lined up for that topic. And I think that kind of has a downstream effects in the undergraduate education too, is that the senior scholars are great mentors for juniors like me. And in exchange, I am grateful that I tend to do more for my undergraduate students or graduate students. It's like a, you know, virtuous circle that you see.
I see that. I heard that you had a unique opportunity to co-teach a class this year.
So yes, I co-taught the largest class in Vanderbilt history called US Elections. We had around 820 students enrolled.
Wow, That's like 10% of the student body in one class.
They became like a campus-wide bonding experience. And we had four instructors. And one of them was the Dean Gear, the Dean of Arts and Science. The other one was NBC Analyst. And the other one was a Pulitzer-winning historian.
Wow! What was that experience like for you?
This is not something that I ever imagined to happen in my life. It was challenging, adventurous, and exciting class to teach. And I think one of the most exciting things that students appreciated about this unprecedented class was that we have an amazing line of guest speakers. So we had the honor of having President George Bush, the House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, Pete Buttigieg, or Julian Castro. And I think that is something that only Vanderbilt kind of offered this year, a very unique class that none of the institutions had it.
1873년, 코넬리어스 벤더빌트가 설립 자금으로 기부한 100만 달러가 없었다면 벤더빌트 대학교는 존재하지 못했을 거예요. 그 기부 정신은 오늘날까지 이어지는데요. 지난 10년 동안 7,500명이 넘는 성공한 동문들과 벤더빌트 대학교의 좋은 동료들이 학자금 지원 프로그램에 4억 달러 이상을 기부했다고 합니다. I know Vanderbilt is known for its financial aid. Can you tell me more about that?
Vanderbilt has an amazing financial aid program. It's called Opportunity Vanderbilt. And through Opportunity Vanderbilt, we will meet your financial need 100%, regardless of whether you need just a little bit or the whole amount to come to Vanderbilt. And we'll meet that need without using student loans.
That's incredible. How did Opportunity Vanderbilt get started?
We knew when we were developing the program in the 2007-2008 timeframe that there were students who were really concerned about the price tag. And at that time, we had students that were graduating with debt. And we wanted to do what we could to eliminate that barrier to access to Vanderbilt. So we launched this Opportunity Vanderbilt program. And in the years that have followed, we've seen that the average borrowing at Vanderbilt has really decreased. And that the number of students who borrow to come to Vanderbilt, even though our cost is relatively high, has also plummeted. So it's doing exactly what we hoped it would do for the families that show the most need. You know, talent doesn't know any geographic boundaries. Students from every part of the globe, from all over the United States, have talent. And if they can get into Vanderbilt, we're going to help them be able to afford it to the extent that we can. And so we don't view it as a handout or anything like that. We view it as an investment in our collective future. And I think that's really the most powerful part of Opportunity Vanderbilt.
Opportunity Vanderbilt는 벤더빌트 대학교 학부생의 65% 이상을 지원합니다. 이 프로그램이 시작된 이래로 12억 달러 이상을 학부생 지원에 사용했다고 하는데요. 무려 만 명이 넘는 학생들이 혜택을 받았다고 해요. 그 혜택을 받은 학생 중 하나인 4학년 요한나 이바노바 씨를 만나 이야기를 나눠보았습니다. Hi, Joanna. So what was your approach when you were looking into colleges?
After getting an idea of generally what the good schools are, I took the time to look at each school and see what kind of classes they offered. And I knew from the start I wasn't very interested in the electronics side of my major. I was more interested in the biology cell side of my major. So I definitely started looking for that in schools. I was definitely also looking at their financial aid program. And I applied here knowing the financial aid program was great. I cried when I opened up my financial aid later. I didn't believe my eyes. I called my mom right away and she was like, how did this happen? We didn't have to get a loan. There was nothing to worry about because Vanderbilt made it so that it wasn't difficult for us to afford it. I think getting an Opportunity Vanderbilt scholarship reminded me that I had earned my place on campus, because I think there's a lot of imposter syndrome that goes on when you get into college. Even if you did everything right, if you had the perfect scores, if you had the perfect extracurriculars, if you think your application was stunning, when you get to school, there's always going to be an element of insecurity or comparison. And I definitely felt a lot of that stepping foot on campus. And I think knowing that not only had I been accepted to the school, but they thought I was good enough to get a scholarship, it was reassurance that I'd actually found the right place. I'm applying to PhD programs in biomedical engineering, and I don't think I could have justified that if I had a mountain of debt that I had to pay off.
That's great. What was it like when you first visited campus?
I instantly fell in love with Vanderbilt. The people were amazing. I couldn't find a single person that was unhappy. Everyone was really excited. Honestly, I'm not able to pinpoint it into words because just stepping foot on Vanderbilt's campus felt really comforting, more so than any other school I had visited. But honestly, it was about fit. Everyone talks about fit, and I remember being really frustrated with that answer when I was applying because they say, you'll find your right fit, everything will work out. And I don't realize how true that is until you start attending the school you're at, because you tend to find a really good place of people that you can mesh well with.
벤더빌트 대학교가 안성맞춤이었던 학생이 또 있습니다. 바로 4학년인 세라 플러시인데요. 축구팀 골키퍼였던 그녀는 SEC 챔피언십에서 벤더빌트 대학교를 승리로 이끄는 데 기여했습니다. 그리고 며칠 뒤 학교 미식축구 감독님의 연락을 받았는데요. 100% 남성으로 이루어진 이 팀에 키커가 필요했던 거죠.
What was it like when you got the call asking you to join the football team?
My roommate and my boyfriend were in the room and I had stepped out when I had initially gotten the call. And I came in and I was like, yo, they want me to be on the football team. And they were like, okay, we did not expect you to say that when you walked back in here. They were so excited, and I called my mom and dad, and they were like, no, you're kidding. And I was like, no, I'm not. Like, they need me out there in an hour. And I was like, I should do this, right? And they're like, yeah. I was like, yeah, I think I should do this. I never expected it to be this big. I just wanted to help. Like, I just wanted to be there to help as anyone else would. So that was my main thing.
Wow, that's so exciting. What was your first day like?
My first real day of practice, I walked out there on the field and the guys were like a little hesitant. And it wasn't because I was a girl. It was because like, are you able to do this job? And when I got out there and I made the field goals, they were like, okay. And we, you know, started high-fiving and I became, you know, part of the team. And I think at the end of the day, it doesn't matter who you are. It's just as long as you can do the job well, that's what matters.
We are about to witness history in college football. Sara Fuller will kick off for Vanderbilt to become the very first woman to compete in a Power 5 football game. History is on the field as Sara Fuller is about to put her right foot into a football, speaking volumes to women around the world. What a day in college football.
세라 씨가 미식축구팀에 들어갔다는 소식은 전국적으로 화제가 되었습니다. 그리고 테니스의 전설 빌리 진 킹, NBA 슈퍼스타 루브론 제임스, 축구 월드컵 우승자 메건 러피노 등의 스포츠 스타로부터 열렬한 지지를 받았죠.
Women in sports deserve this amount of coverage for women's sports. For so long, we were held back and we weren't allowed to do these things. And so now we're really making strides. We're breaking down these barriers. I'm really excited to be a part of that narrative where we're going to change that and make this the norm.
세라 씨가 여성 운동선수의 가능성을 확장한 것처럼 벤더빌트는 모든 학생들에게 이런 혁신적인 사고를 장려합니다. 이런 혁신의 정신은 10곳의 단과대학에 스며들어서 벤더빌트 대학교 졸업생들이 사업을 시작하고 새로운 발견을 해내고 더 나은 내일을 만들어가는 원동력이 되고 있죠.
I think balance is the hallmark of the Vanderbilt experience. It is a medium-sized research university that still believes in the power of liberal arts. It brings together people from all different kinds of walks of life, and through it all is infused this sense of collaboration and support.
My favorite part of Vanderbilt is the people, and it's a very supportive community.
It's the interaction with the students, and it's the relationship with the professors. It brings my soul and like the other students' soul all together, making it a Vanderbilt community.
We are so ready to take risks and innovate at every stage.
I love the students, and I love how they can come from so many different places and rally around this common thing that is Vanderbilt University.